السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، ونصلي ونسلم صلاة وتسليما يليقان بمقام أمير الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه. We begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We laud him and we beseech his help. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides and can misguide, and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides and can guide. And we testify that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we testify that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and that our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now, continuing off the last episode where we left off, is that we said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He desires certain things from us, to attain closeness from us, for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be close to Him, and He wants us to enter Jannah. And so, this is something that is very, very important, especially for the younger generation. And what is this? Is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not send upon us the Qur'an, nor did He send upon us the Sunnah, nor did He give us the Sharia of Islam as a suggestion. It is not something that if we want to do it, we press the green button, and if we don't want to do it, we press the red button. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created this religion, and He has told you that He is the most forgiving and the most merciful, and He wants you to attain closeness to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you don't do so, then you will face consequences from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, with this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desires to forgive you. What is tawbah? Tawbah means that repentance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desires to forgive you so long as you seek Him and so long as you repent to Him. So this takes us back to istighfar, where we said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to seek forgiveness from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish them so long as they seek forgiveness. And then He also says in Surah Nuh, if you seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send upon you abundance of wealth and children and rain and gardens and rivers. So now, moving forward, we mentioned ihsan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ. We all know ihsan to be perfection. Means to perfect ourselves, to perfect our a'mal, to perfect our deeds, to perfect our salah, to perfect our zakat, to perfect our siyam. And so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the most perfect. He goes beyond perfect because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has created perfection. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ, and perfect your actions, perfect your a'mal, perfect your worship, perfect your focus and your khushu' in what you do for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has perfected you and your rights. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never shorted you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gave and He has given you, and He will continue to give you, because that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-wadud, He is the most loving, and He is also the most generous. Now, the next thing is, now we know to perfect our deeds. We know to perfect our a'mal. So now, inshallah, in the following episode, I will be mentioning the next two or three attributes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran that we should follow and we should take into account during this beautiful month of Ramadan. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Please inshallah follow us to watch the next episode on ITV. Jazakallahu khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.